Pinnacle Studio includes a collection of color adjustment tools that lets you correct the color in video clips, or lets you get creative with color grading to achieve a specific mood or look. Here, I've got a clip on the timeline, and to access the color grading features, I just go to Editor and then select Color. There are four separate modes in color grading: Basic, Tone Curve, HSL Tuning, and the Color Wheel. To make better sense of your clip's current colors, you can turn on Video Scope. With Waveform, Vector Color, Histogram, and RGB Parade options. These are slightly out of the scope of this tutorial, but if you need to analyze your clip's colors and you are used to using these options, they will give you a real-time analysis to aid you. Let's look at the options on the Basic tab of the Color Properties. There are options to automatically white balance your clip, or to manually alter temperature and tint. There's also an auto tone feature, or you can manually adjust the tone controls and other basic settings. In addition to creating your own creative look, you can import LUT profiles or lookup table profiles, which can assist you in correctly color calibrating your monitor or display so you know you are seeing the correct colors as others will see them, or just to get particular color profiles quickly and easily. You can import LUT profiles to Pinnacle Studio. For example, I have some here that give more creative effects. Let's look at tone curve options now. Here, you can alter the RGB settings from the input levels, the brightness of the original pixels, to the output levels, the brightness of the corrected pixels. We can alter red, green, and blue at the same time by ensuring RGB is selected, and then click on the graph to create a new point, and then drag the point on the graph until we achieve the look we're going for. We can add as many points as we need to fine-tune things. We can reset the curve at any time by clicking Reset All. We can also adjust the red, green, and blue channels independently by selecting, for example, red, and creating a tone curve just for the red pixels in our clip. Let's turn to HSL tuning now. HSL stands for Hue, Saturation, and Lightness, and we can see we have tabs for all three of these here. We can either manually adjust the values for each color, or if we press the click and drag option, we can select the colors we want to alter right from the color grading panel. For example, if we want to make the sky appear bluer in this clip, we can click on the sky and drag to the right on the color grading video panel. This correspondingly boosts the cyan and blue sliders in the hue category over in the color properties panel. Let's see the same process with saturation controls. Just click Saturation and then the click and drag option, and we can then creatively adjust the sky color again. We can remove all the blue from the sky by dragging to the left, or crank it right up by dragging to the right. Be careful with the extremities of this option, however, as it can create corruption at extreme settings, as we can see in the top right of the clip here. We'll dial it back a bit manually by turning the cyan and blue sliders down. The same applies for lightness. Let's make the pinky purple color of the inflatable our subject is on more intense by cranking up the purple slider. Also, with HSL tuning, all parameters can be keyframed to create color evolutions over time. For example, we can slowly remove the blue from the sky and the water. We can, of course, reset all three sliders with the Reset All option. Finally, let's look at the color wheel. we can adjust the whole color gamut with the color shift wheel. Just drag towards the color that you wish to emphasize. With the slider at the left of the wheel controlling the overall brightness of the clip. To reset either the wheel or the slider, just double-click the slider point. Similarly, we can control the color of just the highlights, midtones, or the shadows of the clip. Highlights are the lightest parts of an image, regardless of color. We can create an overexposed image by boosting the brightness of this wheel, and make it warmer by making the highlights more red or yellow. As the brightest pixels in this clip are the subject's skin tones, changing the color of the highlights will affect these sections much more than the rest of the clip. Midtones represent the middle range of brightness. For example, if we had a black and white clip, the midtones would be gray, and getting a good balance of midtones is often essential in color grading. We can alter the brightness of the midtones to fix a clip with poor contrast. Altering the color of the midtones can create a wash over the whole clip, which may be something you're going for, so use it creatively. Shadows therefore represent the darkest pixels of the clip, and we can make the clip have greater contrast by increasing the brightness of the highlights and decreasing the brightness of the shadows. Shadows also give the image a lot of its flavor tonally. We can make the shadows redder to warm the clip up. Or bluer to make the clip feel colder. So now that you have an idea of the power of color grading in Pinnacle Studio, get out there and make the colors in your next project really pop. But remember, less is often more when it comes to color grading. Don't overdo it, unless you are after a really dramatic effect. Happy editing!